We play ourselves. We watch. We even compete. What makes an esport? Well, any individual or team game that can be played on a level playing field in competition, whether that's live or online. While there are half a dozen top-tier esports, more than 100 different titles are being played competitively around the world. Esports break all boundaries. They're played by men and women across cultures and can be played on consoles, PCs, and even mobile devices. Esports are truly a world sport. Over the last decade, we've seen interest, broadcasting, and live events eclipse those of their traditional sport counterparts. Esports are a massive draw. We love to watch them live, and we love to watch them stream. For people under 30, video games are the most popular media industry in the world, more popular than television, music, or movies. But competitive video game play is not just something we do, it's something we watch. In 2016, more people watched the League of Legends Championships than the World Series, the NBA Championships, or the Stanley Cup Playoffs. That makes the top three sporting events in the world the World Cup, the Super Bowl, and a video game competition. Esports are the sport of the rising generation. Talented players, broadcasters, and managers are filling every level from professional, now to collegiate, high school, and even peewee. To many, esports is the biggest world they've never heard of. But to millennials, it's the future of competition, of broadcasting, and of sport. But not the distant future, the future of today. This is esports.
We're back with the third match tonight of Boise State's competition in Rocket League. We are 1-for-1 tonight, and now we are going up against another university. I'm your host, Jacob Palmer, a.k.a. Gem Mountain. We are here in the Game Pants Esports Arena in downtown Boise, Idaho, and joining me at the desk is Jolly and Chizu. So the last match that we just played was against Park, which we were talking about, you know, a new rival to go, a fairly new program. And speaking of new programs, Drury, who we're playing against now, certainly one of the newer ones and one that we're really enjoying playing against too, like Park.
Not only that, but Doc always tells us, you know, talk about this person, talk about this person. Yeah. Doc loves the director of Drury, Michael Jones. Will lead the esports program, and it is 2019-2020, so we were just talking about a new program. This one's technically newer, and technically one semester newer, so this is their first semester of being involved in esports, and we did play this team actually 2 weeks ago. It was a very, very fun match, and we talked about how we hope to see more of the school in the future, and hey, look at that. Nace has set us up for another match with Drury, this time against the Rocket League team, though, so the players are going to be Athlete, Wombat, and Silent Cat here.
Yeah, and it looks like we're going to be seeing that first round of Boise State players as we have Tachidu, Waiten, Ozcat, and Zazzala coming back here in this game. Again, another best of five.
So what I said earlier kind of makes sense now, right?
Yes, absolutely. Give them a second to breathe as we move into the third game of the evening. Boise State University versus Drury University. And again, Boise State has been looking pretty good. The this crew right here had a little bit of a stutter step as far as earlier against FSC, but they're looking to kind of redeem themselves here as a very aggressive play as Waiten tries to knock out Wombat there, is not able to get the demo, but is able to push him out of the way as Tachidu is going to carry this here on the left-hand side. Waiten looking for a strike is going to be challenged there by Silent Cat and is going to, well, be found wanting as he's got a wide open net here. Boom! Waiten finding the first, and he finds it early. Under 60 seconds, and Boise State strikes first.
It used to be that almost the first goal consistently was at either 4 minutes and 21 seconds or 4 minutes and 20 seconds. Seconds It was something about 40 seconds into the game, they would always land a goal there. So they're keeping with the tradition, 4 minutes and 21 seconds there. All it took was 39 seconds for Boise State to find their first goal.
But a very weird 50-50 here means Boise State is going to be left wide open. And thank goodness for Waiton, as he is able to get something on that ball. And it continues to just stall here. Waiton goes to commit. It goes right over the top of his head. Thank goodness for Tachidou being there to swoop in and save the day. As the athlete gets touch, is going to be turned away. Boise State trying to get some kind of play here. And it goes above Waiton. He barely turns that one aside. Give that kid an award, because that was a saving grace right there for BSU.
Some great saves, but now Waiton is out of boost and just being bullied across the entire field. He missed every single one that he was trying to grab, but it was stolen from him as he was shoved along. A great save there by Tachidou. This has been a very aggressive game from Drury. Boise State making save after save, even though they managed to make a goal in the first minute there. What a save. Tachidou is going to carry that one out and ensure no members of Drury can send that guy home. Wombat, in the meantime, picks up that corner boost. So a good job from Drury here to keep the boost and the rotations in focus.
And they had an unbelievably wide open opportunity, much like this one, but it looks like Waiton's going to turn this one away. And it unfortunately was turned away by, looks like, Wombat in that situation. They would have found that equalizing goal, but unfortunately, just a little bit of bunch ball there, not able to do so as Boise State finds themselves on the attack again.
It almost looks like Waiton never has boost. Whenever we see him, he's sitting at zero, very low, and he's trying to defend here without boost, which makes it very difficult. Tachidou now potentially in the same situation. Ozcat, luckily, was one member there that did have the boost to prevent that one. Ozcat now going to send this one towards Drury's defensive zone. Waiton is picking up the boost. So a good job here for Boise State to start to focus on that boost and recognize that that might be where they have been finding hindrances. A great move by Waiton. The follow through was missed slightly there, but Boise State doing a good job of not following through on a play like that by keeping a defender back just in case. And because of that, Tachidou, who started as the defender on this play, manages to make something out of that one. Silent Cat just barely missing that, thinking he could.
You know what they call that?
What do they call that?
A sick rotation.
Sick rotation.
Boise State has been doing a phenomenal job this time around as far as those rotations are concerned. Again, watch the left and the right-hand side. One individual comes in, the other swoops themselves out as Waiton is here in the wings with a shot on goal. Is not able to find it, but it looks like the rest of his crew, Ozcat, able to put a bumper on there, looking to try to get something going. You see Ozcat peel right back. So that means Boise State University back on the attack with Waiton trying to pick up as much boost as humanly possible. As it looks like Waiton with the shot.
Oh,
his own goal, though.
Oh, my goodness.
As he was trying to just turn that away, was not able to find anything as far as Drury was concerned. Waiton here on the right-hand side of the wall, trying to make something happen here. Ozcat clears it on out. Is this on net? It absolutely is. Athlete going to clear this, as Boise State will not be able to get a second touch. That shot was super, super close, but not quite on net. Again, Boise State up two with a minute 30 remaining. This shot is actually pretty dangerous, as Wombat is able to clear it out off of his own backboard. Athlete going to get a destruction there, and going to get a second one as well. He takes out two of the three members of Boise State. He has got a vendetta, it appears, as it looks like Ozcat with a shot on goal, turned away by Wombat.
Ozcat taken out and immediately responds with a shot there. And even with Drury being as aggressive as they have been, and the ball seems to mostly be on the orange side, Boise State does have those two goals up. So Drury is going to do everything that they possibly can in the last minute of this game to send one home, at least get one goal. And Ozcat with the classic dribble that he does, trying to line that up. Wombat straight down the center of the field. Waiton sends that one away. Athlete is going to go for a high shot there, and Tachidou manages to clear it for Boise State and get it back over to Drury's side.
This is going to Ozcat. He's got a shot on goal, but Silent Cant turns that away. Waiton is going to try to keep this in the offensive end and is able to do so, as it looks like Drury trying to hold on. They've got 30 seconds to find anything, or this might be it for them. Again, Boise State looking really good this time around. Rotations are solid. Shots are spot on, and right now it could be another one, as Waiton has found himself open on the right-hand side. Athlete going to turn this one away, as it looks like BSU now following on the defensive end of things. Waiton with the challenge is not going to find anything here, as it looks like Drury going to take a shot off that backboard. Not able to get a second touch is the blue team, as Boise State will dwindle this last 5 seconds down and pick up almost likely game here number one.
That would have been a really good opportunity for Drury, but we saw there that There was no boost to follow that one up, and they ended up getting a little bit too bunched up on that. So Boise State coming back from that loss that we saw to Florida Southern College, the same grouping now facing up against Drury, taking that first round home. It is a best of five, so at least two more rounds to go. And Boise State is going to try to make this one a shutout because we have not seen a single one today so far.
Yeah, and as far as like this Boise State crew is concerned, they've been doing a really good job, again, focusing on their rotations. Watch how this kind of unfolds again, because it's going to go end up going over to Waiton off of this right-hand side, and he's able to just barely touch it here, but look at how the other individuals are moving on in. Waiton is now going to follow this, and then I believe it's Ozcat is going to fill in right behind him. Tachidou, see, he's right there waiting in the wings just in case something happens here. But Waiton is going to instead scoop this up, give it a nice little, oh, he actually gets pushed out of the way. There we go. And Tachi is there to follow it up. So again, Boise State doing a great job of setting themselves up for success as far as the rotations are concerned. And this is how I explain things. Just, you can't see it behind
I'm
the
apparently
screen,
doing a frog face. But, I guess we get to see. I don't know what I look like until they show me, and then it's always a disappointment.
I'm blissfully unaware. Absolutely. I feel you. So again, just a great series there from both of these teams. And I'm very curious to see what happens here, because it did look like Drury was gaining some ground there towards the end. Yes, they didn't get anything in. There was a shutout as far as that was concerned, but I'm curious to see if Boise State can continue this momentum.
On the start of the game, too, Drury was just so aggressive. Boise State was barely making some of these plays, and you could tell that they were it's not as though they knew that they were going to make those saves. They just so happened to squeak them by and then made aggressive plays off of that. So if Drury can keep the pressure up and find one of those openings, they can certainly get a goal on Boise State. And Boise State's going to try to do the exact same thing that they did last game. Keep those rotations up, constantly have somebody in the corner to snag those boosts, and constantly have somebody rotating around to the opposite side to prevent Drury from getting their own.
Ozcat and Waiton are going to be on the aggressive side here, as it looks like a demolition from Athlete is going to find Ozcat in a wide open net. Is turned away there. Waiton, with a great play, is going to save his team from going down in the early minute of this game.
And that's the boost control right there. Silent Cat did not have any boost to follow up his play. Waiton, however, did. So he's going to follow it up here with a shot just a little to the right there. He is credited with a shot on goal. A bit of a collision for Boise State members as we come down on 1 minute into this game here. It is a best of five, as I mentioned. Waiton trying to follow that up with the touch. I'm not even sure if he manages to touch the ball, but he does get the demolition off the follow-up.
So he at least touched the opponent at right speed to destroy him. So I guess that works out for you.
It was still, you know, it was still an awesome play. From our perspective, something was accomplished.
Exactly, as Waiton is going to continue to try to get this ball out of dangerous position. Tachidou going to be the individual to do that as Waiton picks up the big boost. A shot there from Tachidou is turned away by Silent Cat across here, but nobody there to field it. So Boise State going to peel on back here for a half second, collect some more boost, as it looks like Waiton going to make a play here. He is going to get the stop, and Ozcat going to continue on. Interesting fact, there are two cats in this game.
There are, and what a shot. Ozcat there is going to bring it home. That's 1-0 in favor of Boise State. They just need to maintain this or make another goal to put Drury into match point here. Such good follow-up there, and Drury also doing a good job of responding by trying to snag that boost from Boise State. Right. We've seen a couple situations where Boise State tries to do that, and it actually gets taken right from under their noses. So Drury adapting very, very quickly to play against this Boise State team and to find some advantages. Already 2 minutes now about into
That's
this
a good
game.
Shot.
No defenseman there for Drury. So Boise State says that they will take another one in less than 30 seconds. Waiton going to take that one.
Right over the head of Wombat. Wide open goal. It doesn't get any more free than that. And Boise State takes their second here in game number two. 2 minutes down, and it looks like Boise State's finding about a goal a minute here at this point. Very reminiscent of the first game they played last round. But this time around, Boise State looking even better than they were before. Sure, there are some misplays here and there. Drury is doing everything they can, but it just looks like Boise State has their number all game. They have been on that offensive side. Drury with a couple of shots, but we are seeing once again, Ozcat carries it up. Silent Cat is going to knock it out of the way, and Waiton is going to be in the wings to reset this for Boise State University. Great centering pass there. Waiton to Ozcat, not going to find it, and it looks like Drury is going to be able to clear this out as Waiton tries to corral up some more boost. No, it looks like it's still going to be on that offensive side, allowing for Boise State to gather even more boost and reset this up. Ozcat to Waiton. It's too high, but that shot is low and to the left, not able to find a third point, is Boise State University. But a nice little flick there, and it looks like Waiton will be there to field it for his team. Bumping into Ozcat, who says, hey, get out of my way, as he does the exact same there. And that almost led to a goal on the side of Drury. A little bit of bumper cars from the Boise State teammates. It was almost disastrous.
And we could see from Waiton's perspective, because we've been watching for quite a while, and he was out of boost for so long, how so many of those attempted plays did not go his way because he couldn't follow them up. You could tell it's a scary situation to go into if you think you are either making a good defensive or offensive play, but know that you don't have the boost to follow it up there. So now he is able to take this one around the goal, keeping it from getting one on the board there for Drury Rombat with a shot. Tachidou with a phenomenal save, and Tachidou is doing nothing but performing stellar tonight. He is really, really showing up as one of those players that either performs well or doesn't, and today he is showing that doesn't is not in his vocabulary here. 1:20 on the clock. Boise State up 2, and this is match point for them. So if Drury cannot stop this, they will be leaving this match with 0 rounds.
And it looks like Boise State is not going to relent with the last 60 seconds or so remaining here in this game. And this is one of those things where typically you see a team like this pull off, play a little bit more defensively, but Boise State is feeling very, very comfortable. They're looking to just put one more in, maybe build that safety net. And a little bit of a misplay there as Tachidou gets pushed out of the way by, I believe, Ozcat. And it looks like Wombat going to carry this up. A shot on goal there is going to be very, very high. And Ozcat is able to dribble this out. He's coming across center. Can he take the shot? He is! And there's that safety net we were talking
about. Ozcat with his second goal this game. Wombat there started an incredible play, really doing his best. And actually taking a strategy there, I was going to say, a lot of these plays you can tell when Drury goes on the offensive, Boise State, instead of using their boost to try to hit the ball towards their side, they end up recognizing, all right, they are not going incredibly fast. I can instead bump them out of the way and potentially give my teammates the chance to make a play off
a shot!
Of that. And oh my goodness, Wombat deciding to take a great aerial hit there. Athlete setting that one up. It bounces off of Ozcat there. And just over Waiton's head. So Drury, 1-3 now, at least on the board. Still have a chance to hold this one off, but 31 seconds on the clock is all the time they have.
Drury punished that very, very well from Boise State, just trying to clear it out, trying to do what they were doing before, and he was able to find the spot, the opportunity, and puts it right in for Drury. So at least they're on the board this time around. As Tachidou tries to set this up, Wombat is going to clear it, and it looks like the rest of Boise State falling back as well. Ozcat going to corral this for his crew as well. Looking to clear it out with the final 10 seconds, counting down here. We have seen crazier things, but it looks like Boise State will be taking this as the final seconds dwindle down here in the third game of this series. Boise State apparently just doesn't want to let this ball fall. There it is.
They don't. They, you know, even if it's especially if they're in the lead. Last week, you were not here for the cast on that. Two times we saw. It was not back-to-back. It was one round and then one in between. But they were ahead by 3 to 5 goals, mm-hmm. and each time they dribbled it for 15 to 20 seconds at least and ended up making a goal off of it. So you're like, all right, come on, just end the game. But, you know, they ended up making the final eliminations there and really driving it home.
Yeah, definitely a different story this week. And we have got only one match left. We're 2-for-1. One match left with Rocket League, so stay with us. We're going to see how the night turns out, how we're going to close it out right after this.
Boise State Esports is brought to you by Game Pants Arenas and Equipment, Omen by HP, and Archon Clothing, makers of official licensed Boise State Esports apparel.